Fulham marketed this fixture as their shot at redemption. And while they didn't quite dole out the thrashing of Reading that would have atoned for last season's playoff defeat, there was plenty of satisfaction. The leapfrogging of Cardiff City into the second automatic promotion place, for one thing, and the extension of their mightily impressive unbeaten league run to a 20th match, of which 16 now have been wins. Fulham have relentlessly hunted Cardiff down for weeks and have now edged in front with the finish line moving into view. Cardiff retain a game in hand, at Derby on April 24th, but who can say what psychological effect that eroded lead will have on them from here. A Premier League return the straightforward way, rather than the lottery of the playoffs, would be Fulham's true redemption for 12 months ago, when Reading beat them 2-1 on aggregate in the semi-final. This was far from vintage, but Stefan Johansen's first half goal was sufficient to split the teams and they push irresistibly onwards. The old place went wild when news of Jack Grealish's late winner for Aston Villa against Cardiff filtered through. The whites are going up, they sang. Fulham, 4-3-3, Betty Netley, Fredericks, Odie, Ream, Target, McDonald, Johansen, Norwood 89, Kearney, C, Piazon, Cabano 79. Mitrovic, Cezanyan substitutes not used, Button, GK, Fonte, Christie, Kalas, Kamara manager, Slaviza Jokanovic scorer, Johansen 24 booked, Target Reading, 4-3-3, Manon, Gunter, C, Moore, Allori, Richards, Martin 75, Kelly, Bakuna, Edwards, Swift 59, Aluko, Bodverson, Kerr Morgan 69, Barrow substitutes not used, Hakola, GK, Vandenberg, Clement, Holmes manager, Paul Clement booked, Richards sent off, Bakuna referee, Lee Mason, Lancashire attendance, 19,272. Slaviza Jokanovic warned his players ahead of the contest that a patient approach may be required to break Reading down. Early on, that message had been understood a little too well. The visitors, confidence boosted by an upturn in performances and results since Paul Clement replaced Jaap Stam, settled the quicker. John Dundee Bodverson beat Fulham keeper Marcus Betty Netley onto Leandro Bakuna's through pass and his shot was goal bound until Tim Ream hacked clear off the line. Dennis Odie then made a crucial block from Liam Kelly's shot after Modu Barrow had let Fulham off the hook by miss kicking right in front of goal. Fulham were uncharacteristically slack in their passing, the dimensions of the Craven Cottage pitch suddenly not broad enough. Every time one of their danger men received possession, two or three bright orange shirts would instantly crowd them out. Then, on 24 minutes, everything clicked for the hosts like a switch being flicked to allow electricity to flow. Neat and tidy build up down the left involved Ryan Cezanyan and Matt Target as it so often has this season. Target assessed his options and lifted a delightful ball beyond the Reading defenders into Johansson's path. The Norwegian was just a few yards out and couldn't miss, though Vito Manon did lay a glove on it. The midfielder's eighth goal of the campaign transformed the mood. The Craven Cottage faithful had been as subdued as their team, but Johansson's goal had thousands of cardboard clackers clacking. Someone tentatively started a "We're on our way to the Premier League" chant. Normal service had been resumed and they may easily have added to their lead before the interval. Aleksandar Mitrovic, crowned the championship's best player in March, has been the missing piece of their puzzle since arriving on the January deadline day. He saw four chances come and go in the space of 15 first-half minutes. Two were towering headers, one saved and the other glancing agonizingly wide of the post. A volley found the stand before another off-balance header cleared the bar. Fulham's possession count touched 70% as they searched for a second goal after the break. Mitrovic rattled the post but from an offside position. The big Serbian striker then teed up Johansen with only Manon to beat, but the midfielder couldn't replicate his earlier composure. Johansen was then denied by a low man and save after Target's cutback. Niskan's Cabano almost settled it moments after coming on but drilled across the face of goal, while Mitrovic fired wide when he should have done better. Reading's night got worse when Bakuna was shown a straight red card for an ugly tackle on Cezanyan in stoppage time.